Well, they are the largely unknown executives that head up local councils, but many are paid more than the Premier. Ratepayers are picking up the cheque, leaving some wondering whether it passes the pub test.
As many Sydneysiders battle to pass go, major players in local councils are scoring fat paychecks from the community chest. The CEOs of the cities of Parramatta, Blacktown and Sydney all made more than $500,000 last financial year, including super.
We think that the salaries are outrageous based on the fact that there are no public metrics and public accountability measures in place.
It's more than the Premier, who earns $416,000, not quite as much as the Prime Minister on $607,000, but still far less than fellow CEOs in the corporate world.
Corporate CEOs, you know, if you think Qantas, BHP, Telstra, are paid extraordinary amounts of money, but that is very much performance-based.
In Canterbury Bankstown, CEO Matthew Stewart is on more than $544,000, one of Sydney's highest paid.
I think $200,000 is worth it, $300,000, even $400,000's pushing it. That's like a Porsche a year.
If they are doing good towards the community, then sure, they deserve that.
On the Northern Beaches, former CEO Ray Brownlee was paid more than $740,000 last financial year, including leave entitlements and salary.
If he does the job that he's paid for, then that's what he gets, yes.
That's a lot of money.
Nine News reached out to every council in Sydney. Canterbury Bankstown didn't respond. The Northern Beaches referred us to its annual report. Pay for politicians and other public servants is decided by an independent tribunal, but not for council CEOs. It's left to their own councillors.
There is so much bias and so much ability for salaries of CEOs to be skewed by the emotions or the friendships or the relationships of the councillor group.
The former coalition state government announced a review back in 2021 considering capping pay for senior staff at councils or leaving it to an independent body, but nothing came of it. And now Labor is in power and says it's not a priority.
The local government minister says he's prepared to look into whether the level of remuneration continues to be appropriate. Annalise Bolt, Nine News.